Hi there. Today I will show you around our department. We are focusing on process development of viruses, exosomes, and virus-like particles. Now, let's take a look where all the magic happens. In around 700 square meters of laboratory space, offices and utility rooms is where around 30 colleagues spend working days. We are all dedicated to common goal, to develop effective, fast and robust process of our target molecule. And at the end, to serve patients that are in need for gene therapy, oncolytic treatment or a safe vaccine. This is our chemistry lab and Maya will explain what we do here.
Hi, welcome to the chemistry lab. Here we are preparing different buffers and solutions that are used in process development.
We make regular and specialized buffers that can be applied in sterile and endotoxin-free processes. Buffer compositions depend on the column's chemistry in use.
Thank you, Maya. Now let's head to the BSL2 laboratory.
Hanan, can you please explain what BSL2 is?
Sure, it means Biosafety Level 2 Laboratory. It is used to study moderate risk infectious agents that are present in our community and are associated with humans.
In our laboratory, we are working with different viruses as well as human fluids and human-derived cell lines.
That's why we need to wear our protection equipment. Now, let's head inside.
In a group of enveloped viruses, we are using chromatography as a main tool to study and develop methods for the purification of enveloped viruses used as vaccines, gene therapy vectors, or for oncolytic treatments. The application specifies the required purity we need to achieve.
To study and understand how purification works, we realized we need to take a step back and understand how viruses and exosomes are made in the first place. To do this, we have set up our own upstream lab with all the needed equipment and activities.
During purification, we need to concentrate our target molecule for 100, 1000 to river, 10,000 fold concentration from harvest to final product. In order to achieve this, several purification steps are needed.
Inside concentration, more than 99% of all impurities need to be removed. To be able to track and see the progress of our work, we need to implement state-of-the-art analytical tools.